Hello student, very good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think we were discuss about the synthesis of ribosin A. There are 9 steps starting from the dibenzofuran, how that dibenzofuran will be converted into as a cis dihydrodiol with the proper reagent biotransformation, how enzymatically it achieved. So that type of the description step by step we have discussed neatly in our previous lecture. Today, what we are going to discuss? Today, we are going to discuss the rest of the part, the synthesis of ribosin B. That is the discussion of today's lectures. So, let's begin. So, starting from that structure, we have seen the structure number 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. So, from 3rd onward, we are going to discuss that. Now, let us see the structure number 3rd will be acetonides. So, that we are going to take over here. Let's see how that acetonide 3rd, this is a structure which I am representing here. You can see here this moiety, this benzene ring remains as it is. Now, here the double bond and another double bond should be here. Here will be the both the cis hydroxylation, means both the O group acetonide, this type of the compound. And let me show over here is a methyl group and another one which I am representing over here, which is also as a methyl group, means protection of cis dihydroxyl group with the proper reagent, which is the acetone in other some reagent, biocatalysts are used. So that we are getting as a chemoselective. Chemoselective, do you remember chemoselective means what? Chemoselective means the if compound contain as a number of functional group, out of that whatever the reagent we are adding, the particular reagent get react with that specific functional group and we are going to get the desired product or the expected product. So that type of the thing is called as a chemoselective, which is highly useful or the important as per as modern organic synthetic processes are concerned. So here this is the not this is now here while adding as a OSO4, this is a cis hydroxy group over here like this. So after that, this is the structure number 3 which we have taken over here. First structure, if you remember, the synthesis of ribosin A, starting compound or the precursor is a dibenzofuran. When it is treated with TDO oxygen O2, that is a toluene dioxygenate, it gives the cis hydroxylation, because here the aromatic compound, even though it is a very stable one, at this condition, at this special condition, the aromatic compound, one of the aromatic ring undergoes addition reaction and gives the selectively cis hydroxylation. That is a specialty of that reagent and we are getting selectively, and I think the yield is obtained near about as a 73%. So that is a high yielding product we are getting over there, and that is a biotransformation. And on that This is a structure number first, we can call it as a precursor, which is required for the synthesis of ribosine B. So now, synthesis of ribosine A, not the B. So here, on compound number 1, which is a cis dihydrodiol, further treated with the compound OSO4 and NMO something like that, so that selectively OSO4, that is a, as we know that this is also known, not that one, after cis hydroxylation it requires as a protection, cis hydroxylation get suitably protected by the acetone in presence of some other biocatalyst, and we will get acetonide structure number 2, and that structure number 2, further acetonide structure 2 treated with the osmium tetraoxide OSO4 and some other biocatalyst, selectively we are getting as a this type of the compound, that is the structure number 3, and that structure number 3 suitably we are getting in this structure. This is a cis hydroxylation 2, here we are getting, that is a diastereomer, this is cis diol acetonide, cis diol acetonide, this is called as cis diol acetonide, cis diol acetonide, this is a structure which we have got over there. Now this structure, when treated with camphor sulfonic acid, that is when it is treated with the reagent like this one, the reagent I am going to draw here, PMB, then here is here OMB, here also as OMB, this is a compound, and then this is a CSA, that is a CSA is called as a camphor sulfonic acid or 10-CSA, and the solvent used here CH2Cl2 dichloromethane, and temperature is kept near about as a 15 degree centigrade, the product obtained near about as a 87% yield, overall yield is obtained as a 87%. So that PMP, this type of the PMP, not the PMP, this is a compound, when treated with this, what do you get? This is the compound, from that suitably it can get protected, and we will get the compound like this. Let us see the structure, what you are going to get. This is a structure you are going to get over here. This part of the organic molecule remains as it is, this double bond also remains as it is, this ketal formation that also remains as it is, stereochemically shown over here, methyl group and one methyl group should go below the plane, and now this is the hydroxyl group OH, and that comes above the plane, which is also represented over here like this. Here is a R, here also has a R, one R is below the plane, one R should be above the plane, this R1, and this one is called as a R2. And now R1 and R2, when it is used over here, that is a CSE, it is a strong acid, colorless solid at room temperature, and it is a soluble in water and wide variety of organic substances. This is a compound. And now after that you are going to get as a 10A is equal to 10A. 10A structure, R1 is nothing but as a PMP, PMP, and R2 is nothing but as a hydrogen. R1 is equal to PMP, whereas R2 is equal to H. Now 10B is nothing but as R1 is equal to H, and R2 should be PMP. Cross multiplication, you can say. And this is the structure number 10A and structure number B, depending upon the nature of R1 and the R2. If R1 is there, PMP, and R2 should be H. And 10B means R1 should be H and R2 should be PMP. And when this structure further treated with the reagent, this 10A and 10B are treated with dibal, as we know that. Dibal in presence of CH2Cl2, that solvent is employed here at -78°C. That is a temperature kept. And after this, what do you get? Generally, you know that the role or the uses or the application of the dibal. First, let me tell you the full form of that dibal. Dibal is nothing but as a diisobutyl aluminium hydride. This is known as a, sometime it is referred as a dibal H. This is nothing but as a diisobutyl aluminium hydride. That is the full form of that dibal. Generally, conventional or the general application of that dibal, let me tell you. First, let us see the structure here. N and then aluminium, not N, here is a aluminium, Al, there is a hydrogen attached over there, and then we can draw like this. This is a structure of aluminium diisobutyl. You can write over there like this. This is a isobutyl. Iso means one branch is there, and that is isobutyl, diisobutyl aluminium hydride. This is a structure. And when this type of the dibal, if treated with, suppose you have a starting compound C double bond OOET, ester, that will be treated with a dibal, what do you get? You are going to get C double bond OH, aldehyde. Suppose you have a starting compound is a nitrile. When treated with a dibal, it gives R C double bond OH. Means ester group and the nitrile group get converted into as a aldehyde. That is the application of that dibal, and this is the structure of dibal. Now let us see the what do you get, what kind of the role it is playing in the synthesis of ribosine B. So here after that the deprotection, here the deprotection is carried out by using as a dibal, and now you are going to get the product, this one. This moiety remains as it is throughout here. This bond, this and this remains as it is here, double bond, and then this is the group which is going to remains as it is. Now here is a methyl group, and here one of the methyl group that goes below the plane. In this case, deprotection takes place. Here we are going to get OR2, and here you are going to get OR1, like this, OR1 and the OR2. OR1 here, generally OR1 here, and OR2 must be here. And now again here the compound 11A R1 is equal to PMB and R2 is equal to hydrogen, and 11B is nothing but R1 is equal to hydrogen and R2 should be PMB, and that are the structure we are going to, and this we are getting how much percentage? Generally 30% we are getting as a 30% this, and this we are getting only as a 16%. Very low yield is obtained during this process. And now let us, and when we add the reagent over here, this is a structure number 11A and 11B depending upon the nature of R1 and R2. Now this one treated with methyl iodide and NaH sodium hydride, THF used as a solvent, and stored at room temperature, and the yield which is obtained approximately 90%. Yield is obtained, very high yield, and the compound which we are going to get, which is a 13, what is going to happen over here? Only at this position the R2 group gets changed into as by methoxy, and from 90% from 11, 90% from 11 you can write over here. Now we are going to get here this one, this is a benzofuran, other thing remains as it is, this part of the molecule remains as it is, here only here you can write OPMB, and here we are going to go ME, and here this part of the molecule that remains as it is OO, and this here we can show ME, and here we can show as a methyl group over here, and this is a structure number 13. And after getting as a structure number 13, now let us see what would be the next product. So on 13, this one treated with TFA, trifluoroacetic acid, and THF H2, water H2O, as 9H2 1%, the temperature kept 50°C, and the overall yield obtained 90%. And as we know that TFM is tetrafluoroacetic acid, the acidic condition is used over here, and as we know that the function of TFA, which is used to deprotect the 1,2 diol, and when deprotection is carried out, we are getting the structure number 14, and the structure number 14 will be like this. Let us see here, this is a structure number 14, here oxygen atom, then rest of the compound, double bond remains as it is, Now, this is the structure which remains as it is. Only this part of the molecule, these are the group PM, B, it remains as it is, and here O, a methoxy group also remains as it is, and here the hydroxy group, deprotection takes place, and we will get as a cis hydroxylation as it is, and this is the structure number 14 which we just got over here by adding this reagent. TFE is called as a trifluoroacetic acid. As we know that the structure of acetic acid will be this one, C double bond O, O, H. Instead of this three hydrogen atom get replaced by the fluorine CF3, C double bond O, OH. This is the structure of trifluoroacetic acid. Now let us try to find out the next one, what you are going to get over here. After 14, when it is suitably added with these reagents, one is a TEMPO, it is a free radical reagent, we know that oxone and TBAB, tetrabutyl ammonium, bromide, then CH2Cl2, which is a DCM dichloromethane, room temperature, and the overall yield is obtained 86%. And after, as we know that TEMPO is a free radical, so it gives selectively, the oxidation will be carried out with this, and this remains as it is, and that is a chemoselective, because that tetrabutyl ammonium bromide, it is a phase transfer catalyst, it is function just like as a ionic liquid, and therefore it is highly stereospecific, and we are going to get the structure will be this one. Let us draw that structure over here. Here other part remains as it is, O, P, M, B, then here is a O, M, E, and this double bond, here C double bond O, this hydroxyl group get oxidized, and this group still remains as it is, that is a OH. And this part of the molecule, it remains as it is, and this is the structure number 15 that we have got over here. And now when this structure number 15 treated with suitably the reagent like methyl iodide, Ag2O, aqueous silver oxide, the temperature is kept THF, tetrahydrofuran, 50 degree centigrade as the temperature kept, and 76% of the yield is obtained, and that we will get as a, what do you get over here? Here, this act as an weak base which can abstract the acidic proton, and that hydrogen atom further get replaced by the methoxy group, that is overall change would be observed over here, and you will get the structure number 16. This is a C double bond O remains as it is. Here generally OME, methoxy group, here also as a OME, and here also OPMB, that is still over there, and this part of the molecule, it remains as it is. So this is the structure number 16 we got over here. After getting as a 16 structure, finally what you are going to get, let's see over here. After addition on 16, if you add these reagents, the reagent like as a DDQ, then CH2Cl2, dichloro, methane, DCM, water, H2, that is 4H2 1%, and room temperature 77%. Room temperature and yield is a 77% we are getting. And as we know that, and this is the DDQ, the structure of DDQ, let me draw the structure of DDQ will be this one, C double bond O, double bond O, then here Cl, then C triple bond N, here also C triple bond N, and if you number this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, now you can clearly see at 2 position chlorine, at 3 position also chlorine, 2 are there, therefore dichloro, then 5, 6, dicyanobenzoquinone, dicyano at 1 and 4 position, 1, 4, benzoquinone, that is the name of that compound, benzoquinone. So that is a structure of which is act as an deprotection, because deprotection of this PMB, the full form of PMB is a paramethoxy. PMB is nothing but as a paramethoxy benzyl chloride, that is a full form of PMB, which is used as an protecting group or for masking of that particular, so that the reactivity of that functional group will be decreased. And what is the next? And deprotection can be carried out with the help of hydrogenation, reduction or oxidation. So here is a by reduction is carried out by using as a oxidative deprotection of that PMB, and finally we are going to get our target molecule. As we know that target molecule means whose synthesis is being planned is called as a target molecule, C double bond O, then here O ME, and now here also O ME, and here also hydroxy group that should be below the plane, and this part of the molecule remains as it is, and this is the structure of minus ribosine B. That's the synthesis we have got over here. And so synthesis of, this is a scheme number 3, this is a scheme number 3 which we have described over here, scheme number 3, this one, scheme number 3, which is, synthesis of minus ribosine B. This is the scheme number 3 we have described over here. And as we know that the enzyme, that is a chemoenzymatic, enzyme means a substance produced by a living organism which act as a catalyst to bring about a specific biochemical reaction, or enzymes are protein that function as a biological catalyst. A catalyst is a substance that speed up a chemical reaction, but it isn't change the reaction. So that is a specialty or pesha possibility of that catalyst. I think with this we have synthesized, we have prepared ribosine B. If you observe the structure of ribosine B and ribosine A, both have minor changes over there, and generally we got over here the ribosine A, ribosine B over here, methoxy-methoxy group, but one should be above and one should be below, and that is a change. And here if you remember how we got this one, structure number 50, 60, which type of the special reagent we have used over here. So I think this is the description which we have discussed over here. The remaining because there are the ribosine A to D, so far we have synthesized B. In the next lecture we will try to synthesize the ribosine B, whether it is is there a possibility to synthesize, but as far as our syllabus is concerned only with the ribosine A and B. But let's see what is given in the paper, that we will discuss in our next lecture. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.